found my thrill. On Blueberry Hill.
Hello. Today we're demonstrating the ridiculously low power of NVE's new AAT-009 angle sensor by powering one with a blueberry. Here's the circuit. The sensor is connected to a scope. We have a copper wire as one electrode and a zinc galvanized nail or screw as the other. Fruit provides the ions. We get about a volt, but it's not much current. Here's the setup. The sensor's on the circuit board with a split pole magnet over the sensor. There are three AAT models ranging from 40 kiloohms to 6 megaohm device resistance. Let's start with the 40 kiloohm AAT-003. The impedance is ideal for direct microcontroller interfaces, so it's not ultra low power. Even so, we can power it with a lime, and it draws less than 25 microamps. As the magnet turns, the scope follows the angle. Next, we have an AAT-001, which has a 1.25 megaohm resistance. We can power it with a cherry tomato, and it draws less than a microamp. Now the new AAT-009. We can power it with a blueberry, and the sensor draws less than 0.2 microamps. The signal goes away when we disconnect the berry. But unlike other sensor types, it's self-referencing and indicates the correct position when power is restored. This is important for harvested power, battery-free operation, because harvested power can be intermittent. We can even get enough current from a currant, which is an even smaller berry. So you could say these sensors are berry unique. They're berry low power. They'll run for days on a berry before it dries out, or many years on a small button cell. They also have a berry high signal, are berry accurate, and berry small. Click email or call for more food for thought, or to order sensors, magnets, or evaluation kits. You can get the power sources at any grocery store. Oh.